Niggas acting like bitches, swear these niggas sad. Said you had my back, but that wasn't facts. Niggas all talk, nigga, make them actions match. Your vibes all off, why you acting like a rat? Moving like a snake, like you never ate. Used to be my dog, why I'm on your plate? Niggas screaming that they loyal, folding like foil. When that water get deep, turn niggas unloyal. Niggas from the sandbox, plotting to get they man robbed. He ain't happy with his spot, he just want his man spot. The ops can't get you, but he want his turn on you. Walk off from your dog, he gon' put that burn on you. Tell your nigga no, that's the moment he turn on you. I knew niggas would change, I just had to learn from you. I was niggas' backbone, I was niggas' spine. They wasted my time, I left them behind. Now they want me dead, tell them wait in line. Back up on my grind, it's my time to shine. I was niggas' backbone, I was niggas' spine. They wasted my time, I left them behind.
Yo, what's the deal, man? Chicago Hood Radio. Back again, this time we sitting with my boy. Tell him your name, my boy.
D-Bands Films or Draco Bands.
Man, this nigga got two names. I'll let you know he trying to get two checks, man. Pay attention. Pay the fuck attention. But anyway, man, it's good to be here, man. How you feeling, my boy?
I'm straight.
Shit, man, you know I've been paying attention to you for a while. You know I always stay on your Instagram, man. You be having the females and all of promotion for V Live and videos and shit, man. Hey, that shit A1, bro, for real.
Yeah, love.
But shit, you know what I'm saying? Just for motherfuckers who live under a rock and don't know what's going on, you know what I'm saying? Tell them how you get the name D-Bands and Draco Bands, or it's them like initials for your name, like the D.
Yeah,
you know what
I'm saying? The D come from my first name, you know, Darius. First name Darius, shit. I always been about money, so shit, I just...
So that's where the bands come in, huh?
Just money.
Definitely.
And one of my, this dude I shoot videos for, that's how I got the Draco name. Just name and Draco, shit. Just put them together.
All right, so, you from Chicago, right?
Yeah, I'm from Chicago, South Side.
I was about to say, what side you from? The who area?
I'm Gresham.
That's what's up, my boy, man. Shit, tell me a little bit about the neighborhood and what it was like for you coming up in the neighborhood, bro.
Shit, growing up when we was younger, shit, you know, 10, 12, shit like that. It was Gucci, you know, playing basketball, shit like that, you know. Regular hood shit, playing basketball, fucking with bitches.
Hey man, yeah, you was a big dude, man. Who used to play? What position you played in basketball, bro?
I played all positions.
Oh man, you handled the ball, the rebound, all that shit, huh?
Everything.
That's what it is.
I always had a good point guard, so I ain't really have to play point guard.
That's what it is, man. How the fuck? How tall are you, bro?
6'6".
This motherfucker, he a hooper for real, yo. I'm have to see what this nigga know, man. We got to set up a Chicago artist game.
Man, I do
artists
this
versus videographers.
Man, I do this, man.
Bet.
That shit ain't fair.
He said that he fair,
that
y'all.
Shit gonna be fair, man.
Hey, we gonna set that up, man.
I do this, man.
All right, what schools you attended, bro?
Shit, I went to 3 high schools.
Man, name them off, man. Shout them out.
Washington. Over East, 5 over East, Finger and Bogan.
You with the Finger, man? What year you graduated Finger, bro? I mean, not graduated, but what years you went to Finger, pardon?
I was a Finger 08 to beginning of my senior year 2010, you know, 08, 09.
Oh, shit, yeah. You know, I went to Finger, I came out then, 01, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, damn, I don't know why the fuck I ain't paying attention to you, bro. That's crazy,
yeah,
bro.
I was a Finger.
That's what it is. And you said Bogan, right?
Yeah, Bogan. I graduated from Bogan.
Oh, that's what it is. What year did you graduate?
2010.
That's what it is. So, tell me what type of student you was coming up in school. You know what I'm saying?
Student.
Was you a class clown, or was you there to learn what was going on with you?
I was hooping, man. I was in school hooping. That's all I was doing.
Hey, I know the perks to hooping.
I ain't a stupid motherfucker, though. Decent grades. I graduated.
That's what it is. Hell yeah. That's all that matters. You got that paper, my boy.
Yeah, that's just, school just ain't keep my attention. That's all. They wasn't teaching shit, really. Teaching the basic shit. Motherfucking my count, read, and all that shit. So
Right, that was gonna lead me to my next question. Like, what was your favorite like subject in school?
Math and science.
Definitely, that's what's up. Hey, you gotta learn how to count that money, man. Yeah, and you gotta learn how to dissect shit when you need it.
Yeah, math and science, man.
No
I
cap.
I kept an A in math and science.
That's what's up, man. All right, so being from Chicago and shit, you know what I'm saying? Have you ever had a chance to visit the different parts of Chicago? You know, like north, west, south, and east, my boy.
Yeah, I've been on every side. I slide out west. I ain't really too familiar with it. Up north, I just be out there if I'm doing some shit. But south and east side.
All right, so just a light question. What part of town you can like safe to say like you know what I'm saying you fucking with the most?
Oh, the south side. But shit, the south and the east side to me it's really the same shit. It's just ain't really no dividing. So I just put the east side as the south side.
Man, where they getting it popping at, man? Where all the fifis and shit, man? Where you go to when you going hunting, my man?
I'm a Southside nigga.
That's what it is. Southside. Southside run this shit.
Southside, man.
That's what it is. All right. Being from Chicago with a lot of shit going on, it's a lot of powerful people, a lot of leaders and shit going, just that's out here, you feel me? Pardon me. Who can you say that you look to and, you know, as a positive influence and, you know what I'm saying, just wanted to make you do better or, you know what I'm saying, just create music or whatever, just inspired you? Who was somebody in the hood that inspired you?
In the hood? Shit. Really,
from your neighborhood?
Really? Shit. I'm just saying me, really. I ain't really look up to nobody. I looked up to my cousin. He got killed in 06. I was a shorty. Yeah, really my cousin, my two cousins, one locked up, he got 75 years, and other one dead, so shit, really.
Definitely was already on your shoulders, huh?
Yeah, really, just shit, me and my circle, shit. My cousin, I really only hang with my cousin, I got a couple homies from the hood that I keep around, but.
I feel you. That's what's up, man. R.I.P. them, man. Shit, you know, we got strong motherfuckers out here, man. Some look up to some and some don't, shit. But, hey, as long as you get the job done, that's all that matters.
Yeah, you know, I really, looking up to motherfuckers, it was like Master P. Master P, 50 Cent. And it was 2 main motherfuckers I really looked
real
up
to. Real powerful motherfuckers, yeah. Real shit. All right, being from Chicago, you know what I'm saying? You visited, you know what I'm saying? All areas of Chicago. I just heard you was just on the phone with your guy. He said y'all was gonna sit down and get something to eat. You a big dude. You feel me? It's only right I asked this question. what restaurant do you fuck around with in Chicago? You know what I'm saying? What restaurant would you recommend to play for somebody and want to be on your plate?
Man, I ain't really got no favorite food, so. I eat whatever, really. Shit good, I'm eating it, man.
Hey, long as that shit got some seasoning on it, huh, man?
Shit good, I'm eating it. You know, I like pizza and shit. Pizza, burgers and shit.
Oh, so you fucking with all, like I heard you say, you fuck with all the hood spots.
Yeah, I fuck with gyro spots and shit like that.
Hey, niggas love that. Niggas love that good old lamb meat, boy. Real shit. Hey, so man, if y'all fuck with D-Bands, when y'all come out here for a feature or get some work done, man, know y'all getting them gyros and shit, bro. You feel me? That's a big hit in Chicago. All right, now let's talk about your projects and you know what I'm saying, everything you got going on, because, man, you down there like a James Brown, bro. You doing all kind of shit out here, bro. Like, I be paying attention, bro. Let's talk about D-Band Films, first of all. You know what I'm saying? Because that'd be like the first thing that jump out at me. You know what I'm saying? Like the logo and shit. And you know what I'm saying? How you edit your videos. And you know what I'm saying? Just how you patting your shit, man. What inspired you to, you know what I'm saying, to jump into videography and all that?
Shit, really? Really, I was, we was rapping, but you know, in Chicago, it wasn't the video scene wasn't here yet. You know, this back in like 07, 08.
Right.
It was just, you know, motherfuckers uploading the little picture videos and shit. Like, only motherfuckers that had videos was like Kanye and them and shit. So.
Right.
So, I was just looking into it. You know, I used to watch BET, what the shit was. Access Granted, whatever.
Yeah, Access Granted. Yeah.
I used to just watch, and I really learned off that. It's like looking at that shit and just figuring out angles and shit. Just looking at the video, like, man, how the fuck they shoot that? And then I when I finally got into it, I was just trying the shit, kept trying the shit, and I got the shit.
So y'all hear that?
I learned off just watching and looking at it, like, shit, math and science, shit. If I shoot this motherfucker like this, it's gonna look like this.
Y'all hear that shit, man? See what I'm saying? You ain't gotta sit around and be lazy and don't know what's going on. It's all type of shit you can learn out here, man.
You don't need no school for the shit either. That's, I went to college, I was hooping in college, but like I took the classes and the shit, but they were teaching me the basic shit, like shit I already knew, so it was pointless. Staying in the class, I'm like, man, fuck that shit. Got out of shit. 3-4 years in, shit, made my name. Motherfuckers started knowing who I was.
Definitely, man. I definitely see you shooting a lot of videos and shit, man. Like, can you name a few?
Man, I really shoot a lot of models. I can shoot music videos, but the only motherfucker I really shoot for is a nigga named Nighty.
Oh, okay,
right,
bet.
Chicago, Southside, and Hunnets.
Bet. Okay, so, man, let's just jump straight into that, man. The models, the D-Man's eye candy. Shit, let's jump into that, man.
What's
the inspiration for that? What's the motive for that, man? Because, hey, you're doing a good job with that, bro.
At the time, motherfuckers was taking pictures. I was like, man, shit, I'm going to get a bad bitch and do a video with it, like. Make the bitch get in the shower and tub and all that shit. Shit niggas wanna see.
I love
deep dance, I can't believe you. Damn, I love your legs. Can't believe your legs. Wrap me in your legs. While I'm in between your legs. Squeeze me with your legs. While I'm kissing on your legs.
Know what a nigga wanna see. I know what I wanna see, so shit. I know niggas gonna watch this.
Exactly.
I know niggas gonna watch this. I know females gonna watch this.
It's definitely a good promotion tool, I tell you
that. And then shit, that shit started picking up. Shit, I got a name off that. It was really the first motherfucking city to do it. It was probably a couple niggas before me, but I got the shit going.
Nah, for real, man. That's looking good, and that's definitely a great look for them females. Like, females, if y'all watching this shit, man, y'all need to get up with bro, you know what I'm saying? Because he got that shit looking real good. Like, if y'all don't know, follow him, bro. Follow him.
It's really shit, one of the best promotion tools for the models. Like, if they really trying to be in music videos, you got to give a motherfucker
That's like a demo.
Yeah, it's a demo. Like, you got to be able to perform in a video. There's been a lot of girls in videos, they can't even perform in a video.
And it also go hand-in-hand with the artist.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I got like a little segment that I do that I hook up with females and they just like send me videos, shit called Thang of the Week. You know what I'm saying? Thick hustlers with ambitions and goals. You know what I'm saying? I be trying to promote that same energy. But you know, I always come on your page and give you the crown, like, boy, you the king, keep doing it. I always did that and didn't even know you from shit. You feel what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's love.
So, man, I definitely salute that. Hey, but like I said, females, y'all need to get up with him, man. Follow him on Instagram, you feel me, at DBandsFilm. You feel what I'm saying? It's called D-Band's Eye Candy, right?
Yeah, D-Band's Eye Candy.
Man, y'all check that out, man. He got that shit going on for the females. Real shit. So, let's go to this, man. Let's talk the V-Live scene. What you got going on with V-Live, man? I see you doing a whole bunch of promotion and shooting for them, man. What's going on with that?
Be live shit. Shit, they picked me, shit, basically. Shit, they saw my work, shit. I went to the casting call, did a little film, they casting call, shit. They picked me, shit.
The rest history,
I just know how to, I started, but like, really, I was the only motherfucker in Chicago shooting shit in clubs. Like, I started that, like, me and
bro, that shit is everywhere else.
Yeah, it's everywhere. It was promoter, group of promoters. It was Murder, and Party Boy Shaq, and Mo 773.
Right.
But shit, they was the first motherfuckers to hit me. Like, shit, cash me out to do the shit. I brought the shit to them, they shit hit me. And shit, that shit taking off. Every club in the city doing it, not out of time, motherfuckers doing it. You just can't even get a camera in the club.
Exactly.
Video camera.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. You know, I follow this shit a lot. You know, I used to watch a lot of the Smacks and the Scoob Dude videos, and them niggas used to be in the club with their camera with them stars.
Yeah.
And they made like a living off that shit, bro. Like, for real. Like, you couldn't go nowhere without seeing a Smack DVD with motherfuckers in the club performing and all that type of shit. So,
yeah.
And Chicago, it's like Chicago just don't follow them type of trends, man. And them the looks that you know what I'm saying, the artists need.
Yeah.
You know, these people want to see you out here doing your thing. You know what I'm saying? Whether it's a club, the crib, whatever. You see what I'm saying? So that's definitely a good look, man. That's more exposure for the artists, and they don't even know it.
For the artists, the club, everybody, shit, a video. Shit,
exactly,
Bring the club money. That's why everybody's doing that. It's, shit, you have a cracking night that night, motherfucker stole 20 bands. Oh, that club cracking. We going there next week.
Exactly.
They saw this video. That's what happened in the club last week. Shit, we going to go there. We going there next week.
Exactly.
That's how that shit go,
for real.
Keep the business going.
For real. Okay, so let's jump straight into Draco Bands, man. I've been seeing Draco Bands out here, man. You know what I'm saying? Moving like he got a machine behind him. Get this nigga Draco Bands giving away money, all type of shit, man. What's up with Draco Bands, man? What's going on with the project, man? What's the name of the project?
My EP, it's called Intro.
Intro.
Yeah, the Intro.
Why you name it Intro, my dog?
Shit, my introduction to into the music. Shit, I've been rapping since, you know, fucking around like 08, just working on my shit. But this I dropped In My Bag. That's my first song I ever really put out, like, on platforms or anything, YouTube, all that shit.
Okay, so let's backtrack a little bit. What started you to, you know what I'm saying, create music? You know what I'm saying? What sparked that flame for you?
Shit, I always been into music. You know, I was hooping, shit. You know, before the game, I listen to music.
Hand to hand. That's right and left. Hand to hand.
I just listen to music, Biggie, all type of shit. I used to listen to Biggie before my games, all type of shit. But then my cousin, he was rapping. They got killed back in 06, named Mello. He was rapping. Shit, once he died, shit, I used to just freestyle and shit in my head and shit before the games, and then heard, let a couple motherfuckers hit me rap, and then it was like, I mean, you decent, I want shit then, really.
Right, I feel you. You was trying to craft that shit.
I was trying to grab a motherfuckers and shit, they was supporting me, so shit, after that, I jumped into the video shit. Now I know how to shit shoot the videos. I think it's time to get back rapping.
Definitely, man, because, hey, can't nobody push you like you push yourself, my dog, for real. Can't nobody, you know what I'm saying, craft your shit the way you want it. Can't nobody have it sounding the way you want it, so that's a good, you know what I'm saying, a good look.
I do all my shit myself.
Definitely, oh, man, yeah, see, this motherfucker, he wear many hats
see,
over
see
here.
See the mic in this bitch, this $1 million house.
Let's get it, my boy.
$1,400 or just $1 million house.
You feel me? No bullshit. Hey, pay attention, y'all, man. Giving the game away, man. All right, so let's talk a little bit more about Intro, man. Producers. Any producers you connected with that project?
I ain't really connected with none, but I find beats, shit, I hit, shit, purchase them motherfuckers and shit, there you go. But I fuck with Rock T.
Okay.
Yeah, producer out in Texas.
Oh, that's what it is. Yeah, what's going on?
I think he out in Texas. I think that's what he said. He out in Texas.
Shout out to Texas.
Instagram.
Salute to Texas, Dallas, all that
Rock
shit,
T,
Port Arthur, all that shit.
He produced In My Bag.
H-Town.
Yeah. He produced two of my songs, In My Bag and Do What I Want.
Yeah. Y'all go look him up. Rock T, right? Y'all go look him up.
Yeah.
So, what was the angle with this? You know what I'm saying? I know you were saying it was the introduction back, you know what I'm saying? To let motherfuckers know you in this shit. You see what I'm saying? But, like, what's like your the final outcome you want from this album? Like, what's the angle you trying to go?
This really just step one. I ain't really looking for too much, you know. It's just letting motherfucker know, shit, I don't just shoot videos, shit. I do everything.
Get down, real shit.
I get down, and I can hold my weight with the motherfuckers, with the big dog.
Definitely, hey, man, because what's the one you got the video for? Hold on, man. You was talking some shit on there. I don't know if people paying attention to what you saying, man, but you was talking some deep shit. What was the angle to the behind, man? And what was the inspiration for the video?
That's just shit, real life. Shit that go on, shit motherfuckers have seen, motherfuckers went through. That was real life. Shit. And I just put it in the story format, you know?
Like, you got a line on that. I think you was saying, you said you ain't moving right. Why you moving like a snake?
Hey,
man. Hey, explain that, man. Cause,
Chicago, man. Niggas will snake you for the smallest shit, you know, or for nothing.
Oh, yeah, just man. Definitely.
Just jealousy, you know. That's shit. Why you moving like a snake, shit?
Real shit.
Niggas supposed to be homies. Why that shit? Why you moving like that?
So it's safe to say, like, man, that song, like, really, you know what I'm saying, molding motherfuckers, telling motherfuckers, why you out here eating, watch yourself.
Yeah.
Real shit. All right, what's the other single you got out, In My Bag?
In My Bag, yeah.
Man, what's that club, about? Man. That's some up-tempo shit right there, man.
That's
what's
the club, man. I just made that because, shit, you know, I work with the females. Shit, strip club. I work in the strip club. I just, a club banger, shit. Some bitches can shake their ass too, you know. Niggas get money, you know, everybody wanna get money, shit. That's a theme song. Shit. Man, I'm in my bag.
Yeah, you in your bag, man. I see you trying to get that bag away too, honey. You got that contest going on. Tell the people about the contest you got going on with the In My Bag thing.
$200 twerk contest, you know. I might raise it, I don't know. Might raise it to shit, 400-500.
Hey man, y'all hear him? Hey, females, ladies, y'all hear him? Go get that money.
$200 shit. Best twerk video to my song, shit.
Y'all hear him? Go get that money.
That motherfucker tag.
You recently performed that song? When you performed that at V-Live? Man, what was that experience like, man?
That's cool. It was cool, shit. That was my first performance.
I'm just finna ask you that, man.
Yeah, I should be performing soon again.
That's what's up, man. I did see you on that. You was laid back and cool on that motherfucker.
Cool. Yeah, I'm a big nigga. I ain't finna be.
Yeah, exactly. I can't see you out there Harlem shaking and shit, man.
I ain't finna be going out there. I get teed. Shit. I was just doing that bitch a rap, but no emotion, no delivery behind the shit.
Okay, right. Definitely. You know, I feel you. Yeah.
Just rapping the words on the beat. But nah, I deliver words, certain words. I gotta say like this, say like that. I know how to deliver shit now, basically.
Definitely. Hey, man, if y'all listening, man, you feel me? You definitely gotta sharpen your shit, man. You see what he just said? He just said some key shit. He was just saying he was just going in the booth. You see what I'm saying? Just knocking it out opposed to, like, showing emotion and feeling in his, you know what I'm saying, in his crowd. Like, that's depth, because people feel that. When you rap that shit like that, when you rap it in a certain way, people feel it. Like when DMX rap, he that nigga wears emotions on his sleeve, so they feel that shit. That's what people get attached to you for. So, man, big salute to that. Let's talk independency or you know what I'm saying, being signed. What side of the fence you on when it comes to being signed or independent?
Independent.
Why you choose independence?
Shit, I'm independent right now. Shit, I do everything that's just in.
That's all a nigga know, huh?
That's the type of person I am, but I wouldn't say I wouldn't sign a deal. It'd be a partnership, though, if I was to sign a deal, because I'm too creative. I need creative control and all that.
Definitely.
Too creative. And marketing and all. It'd be a partnership.
So. The 360 is definitely out the door. Definitely.
I need some control.
Right, I feel.
I do the videos, photos, everything. So
it's like you don't need nobody for shit. You need the checks for all that.
Yeah. If anything, I just need a partnership, a name.
Exactly. So if a label, if you could choose a label, you know what I'm saying, we just gonna hypothetically speak, and they got a real, you know what I'm saying, a credible deal for you, you know what I'm saying? And you can like select where you wanna end up at, what would be the dream label for you to end up at? If everything came out right and you could select where you going?
I'd probably go with Def Jam or nothing. I'd just sign a dog for if maybe 50 if he was to do some shit. 50 dog. I just sign with an artist. I wouldn't even sign with.
Yeah, because artists know artists' pains. You know what I'm saying?
I signed to another artist, like 50 dog. I signed to Gucci.
Yeah, and they definitely paying you. They not bullshitting with your money, too. I ain't seen nobody come out about them saying they ain't getting paid.
Yeah. Definitely Master P. I sign
no one. Master P, hey, man, you know Master P infamous for throwing niggas $1 million. He'll see you somewhere and throw your nigga. Straight up.
Same type of
niggas,
you know?
Straight up. No cap. So y'all hear that, man. If y'all listening, man, pay attention, man. Independence is the route. You see what I'm saying? But he named some artists that's on the same wave he on that he assigned to. So salute PRE. No Limit, you feel what I'm saying? 1017, salute all them guys. Alright, let's go to some questions, you know, about social media. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, let me back up. Let's talk about the show you did. You know what I'm saying? We talked about it a little bit, but you know what I'm saying? Let's talk about you on stage from that show at the V Live. What's some do's and don'ts for you at a show?
Shit, what I need to do? Shit, get in the gym. Boy, that shit
get you tired,
that
man.
Shit, man.
That's cardio, man.
I did that shit to get you tired, but shit, I don't. But damn,
yeah.
I need to hurry up. I need that motherfucking win back.
Hey, y'all, pay attention, man. D-Man's giving you the game, man.
Shit, that's about it. Shit, what I need to do.
That's what's up. Who would you like to share the stage with? Like, who would you like to perform with?
Probably some of the artists I
name,
you know.
Dawg. Social media, man. Drop your social media right quick, man. Shout out your social media out.
D_Bands with a Z. Films with a Z. Draco Bands. Damn, what the fuck is it? Draco Bands
1713. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
With a Z. I
follow you. I was about to tell you that 1713, my nigga. Go ahead.
1713 ENT.
They're my three. Alright, so you know, people use their social media for all type of shit. Trolling, hating, FBI shit. bitches be making fake pages to see if niggas cheating, and vice versa. How you use your social media, bro?
Shit, all three of them business. Video, photo page, music page, label page.
So, man, you be seeing a lot of the fuck shit that be going on when you be, you know what I'm saying, promoting your business on there?
Yeah, I see everything.
Man, so tell me what you think about the whole Soulja Boy shit. You see what I'm saying with him saying, you know what I'm saying, Drake stole his style and he set the tone for you know what I'm saying, rappers and labels to, with these cameras, to see all this YouTube shit and all this shit. What you think about that? How you think he got some truth to that statement? Yeah. Like he was one of the pioneers to this, you know what I'm saying, the cameras following your everyday lifestyle type shit.
Not the everyday lifestyle, but definitely YouTube, internet shit, really. The internet, independent shit on the internet.
Yeah.
He definitely started that.
Definitely.
First, shit, the first motherfucker on YouTube watching the You video and all that, whatever video was called. Soulja Boy shit, he definitely started that.
So did you you seen this interview, right, with the Breakfast Club, right?
Yeah.
So you see the guy said Drake stole his style and his lyrics and shit, man. And he actually sung the song, and it's like one of his songs, man. What you think about that? What you think about him and Drake?
Just like what motherfuckers do today, shit. Same shit Jay-Z did to motherfucking Biggie.
Real shit.
Jay-Z.
Swagger jacket.
Swagged out all Biggie shit and shit. Made it his shit, you know? I don't feel like it was really stealing. It's just... Like, you said the same exact shit. Like,
right, he could be paying homage.
That's paying homage. Motherfuckers do it all the time.
Big thing that's going on with Tekashi 6ix9ine, with him going to trial and possibly facing like 45 years of life and all that, but he cooperating with the police. What's your stance on niggas cooperating with the police but sweaty hard and all that type of shit, man?
You weren't never with the shit, you know? And snitch, basically. Just, you weren't really with it.
Crazy shit. That man is really in there cooperating with the police on these guys. He said, oh, well, they was plotting to kill me and all this and this, that, and the third. Hey, man, you was with them guys, though, man. How you gonna tell the business?
Yeah. Shit, they plotting to kill you. Shit, you kill them. Fuck. Get them before they get you. Shit. I ain't even tell the police. They trying to
kill me. So you definitely against that snitching shit he
Definitely.
That's what it is. Let's talk entertainers and just being just stalked by the police. I just want to say that, like, because it seemed like we got a black cloud over all our entertainers, man. What you feel about, you know what I'm saying, the entertainers and these mishaps with the law and all this shit, man? You know, from R. Kelly to Bill Cosby to fucking Chris Brown being wrongly accused to the YME Melly or whatever. What you feel about these entertainers? Even to Juel Santana just going to jail and shit. Like, what you feel about this stance? Or do you think we being like a heavy scope is on us?
Shit, the same shit have been going on forever. Shit, you just gotta find a way to maneuver through shit. You know? But they definitely own. They definitely own black entertainers, you know? And shit, you just gotta find a way to lay low and shit, do what you do.
Yeah, man, you definitely gotta move shit different, man. Like, for real. It seems like they definitely on our ass, bro. Like.
Nah, but that's cause shit, motherfuckers. If motherfuckers have made it already, make some shit for the black motherfuckers, we can go through that instead of trying to go through them. Motherfuckers, it's a lot of entertainers that got money, they can put their shit together and make a whole nother joint, like shit Cube did the Big Three.
But see, that's
the motherfucker, Cube got the Big Three, and then you got the NBA, shit, we can just run through this motherfucker.
That's the key thing.
Go through this motherfucker.
That's the key thing.
Spike Lee could have been there some black film shit.
But see,
more directors running through that motherfucker. More movies running through that motherfucker.
But see, don't you think it's something wrong with that picture and why these brothers ain't did that? Like, it's a system to everything. It's a system to everything. I don't think they don't know. I think it's something that's holding them back from doing that, because these brothers is, like, getting money for real, like, on the real level to do that shit. But it ain't been done.
Shit, they don't want to do it, shit. I feel like they don't want to do it. Shit, Cube is one of them. Shit, he did it.
True.
Cube was a legend, same era as them, shit. He said, fuck it, I'm going to do this.
True, definitely.
But he always been a fucking type person since back then, like, man, I'm gonna do this. This is what
we doing. But see, D-Bass, this shit is like,
you gotta
this shit
be that type of person.
This shit is real deep though. Like, you definitely gotta be that type of person. But this shit is real deep when you playing ball like that, out here in this world and being a black man owning businesses. I'm talking about Fortune 500 companies. Like, it's a lot of responsibility and shit that come with that, bro. Like, you got to think about way back in the day when these people, just because we had our own banking system, our own businesses, you know, Black Wall Street, they bombed that shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? So, with that being said, that's all they doing to us right now. It's just they ain't using a bomb. They bombing all our motherfucking black entertainers, bro. And if you just black and then you in this world and you doing whatever you doing, if you owning some shit, I believe they getting on your ass to make you lose that shit.
Oh, shit, you just got have your shit right.
But I definitely feel it's a black cloud over the the African American dollars and all that shit.
That's always until we figure out a way to get the shit off.
Pros and cons of social media.
Don't get on that incriminating yourself. And then somebody snitched on you.
Okay, so
use that shit for what it's for. Shit.
Promotion and being with family, exactly.
Memories and business.
Alright. We always close this, you know what I'm saying, this interview. You know what I'm saying, with asking a question about the Chicago violence, pardon me. What do you think about the Chicago violence, and what do you think is some solutions that we can maybe, you know what I'm saying, try to produce a better situation with this gun violence that's going on in Chicago?
Shit, these same questions. Same shit motherfuckers been saying for years. Ain't no money out. It's money out here, but motherfuckers that got it.
Oh, it's money out here. Niggas just too lazy to go get it.
Motherfuckers that got it ain't trying to build nothing. Like I said, they ain't trying to build nothing. Like, honestly, all Chicago missing is a label. But I see Ferris and them doing something.
Definitely. Yeah, shout out DJ Ferris. He got a tape coming out, too.
DJ Ferris, they putting something together.
This Chicago, yeah.
That's all Chicago missing. It ain't even a major label, it's just we need a home base to run our paper through like Atlanta do.
Come on with that little honeycomb hat out, Ferris. We need it.
Like Atlanta get a set of artists, man. You see they got a set of group of artists at one time. Every time is Baby, Gunna, and couple up, 21, all them. That's their wave, they running them through, that's who they pushing. Next wave, get ready. That's all. Chicago got their little way right now with Zay, Cowboy, Polo G,
definitely,
Rockstar Roadie,
definitely.
And that's the Chicago way right now.
I like the young Chicago. Yeah.
Yeah. Next way, this is what we pushing.
All right, so y'all hear that, man? Basically, man, get some jobs out here. Get a label out here. Get these little motherfuckers, get their little time consumed so they can be productive instead of destructive. You see what I'm saying?
On the other hand, shit, the artists and shit can't be cheap, though.
Definitely.
Artists can't be cheap.
Speak on it, bro. Speak on it.
You got to, shit. If a DJ got a tape and he got slots, shit, hit him. You going to get heard. He's selling slots for a tape. Hit him. Amara's good all the time. Amara's got tapes all the time. Shit, Amara's run a lot of motherfucking artists. The Amara's,
shout out to Amara.
Mo Bay, he starred. He that's a Cowboy DJ.
Mm-hmm.
He doing his thing. He's starting at DJ Saint Picasso, Amara's, fuck Vita.
Salute Vita.
I fuck with a lot, man. I fuck with a lot of DJs. But, DJ Reese. Can't forget DJ Reese.
That's what's up. Alright, so, you know, we finna shut it down, man. Glad I was able to come out, you know what I'm saying, pick your brain a little bit. Maybe, you know what I'm saying, we can have another sit down, we get more in depth with this shit. You feel what I'm saying? Shout out your all your info, anything you got coming out. All that shit, man. Let the people know how to contact
you. Shit, just follow me on Instagram, shit. D_BandsFam, Z's, all Z's instead of S's. Draco Band 1713,
1713 ENT. That's what it is. So, man, y'all hurry up, go follow Fool. You know what I'm saying? He got a lot of shit cracking. Oh.
Go get my motherfucking single.
Damn, yeah, man.
In my bag.
Tell them the EP and all that shit.
In my bag on all platforms, Apple Music, Spotify, whatever you listen to music on, YouTube, on everything.
All right, so, man, y'all make sure y'all go check out D-Bass Films. Check out Draco Bands for that new EP intro. You feel what I'm saying? Go fuck with him. Go fuck with his Instagram, all that. Man, love my boy, you already know what it is. Chicago Hood Radio, Go TV, we gone. Man.
Niggas acting like bitches, swear these niggas sad. Said you had my back, but that wasn't facts. Niggas all talk, nigga, make them actions match. Your vibes all off, why you acting like a rat? Moving like a snake, like you never ate. Used to be my dog, why I'm on your plate? Niggas screaming that they loyal. Folding like foil when that water get deep. Turn niggas unloyal. Niggas from the sandbox plotting to get they man rock. He ain't happy with his spot, he just want his man spot. The ops can't get you, but he want his turn on you. Walk off from your dog, he gon' put that burn on you. Tell your nigga no, that's the moment he turned on you. I knew niggas would change, I just had to learn from you. I was niggas backbone, I was niggas spine. They wasted my time, I left them behind. Now they want me dead, tell them wait in line. Back up on my grind, it's my time to shine. I was niggas backbone, I was niggas spine. They wasted my time, I left them behind.
Go TV. Get it. I hear these rappers, they talk about money, but you know the game is put up or shut up. Came in this bitch with my gun and my balls, and I told all my niggas I'm never gon' let up. I need a bitch who gon' push me to get it, and if she don't get it, I shut her the hell up. She gon' pull up with a top in the trunk, and we gon' fuck like I ain't seen her in months. I know this your bitch, I've been needing once, but that's not the case, so let's get it expunged. Can't see these niggas, they not on the radar, but I don't forget, so they still get the AR. I hear these rappers, they talk about money, but you know the game is put up or shut up. Came in this bitch with my gun and my balls, and I told all my niggas I'm never gon' let up. I need a bitch who gon' push me to get it, and if she don't get it, I shut her the hell up. She gon' pull up with a top in the trunk, and we gon' fuck like I ain't seen her in months. I know this your bitch, I've been needing once, but that's not the case, so let's get it expunged. Can't see these niggas, they not on the radar, but I don't forget, so they still get the AR. I'ma hit Paco, them bullets colossal, and we serve the beat like it's beans and tacos. Straight from the dirt, where you can get ounces, the same place that you can get cheese on your nacho. Tell me I'm lying, call or Go TV and book you some time.
Those are dumb.
Videos?
Yeah,
dude.
Don't waste my time, man. Don't ask me my price and then get mad at my price.
Hey, it'd be a lot of that going on, man.
Don't ask me my price and get mad at the price I give you. You ask my price, you ain't negotiate. That's up to you to negotiate, to come to me with. If I tell you $800 for a video and you can't do $800, then you throw your budget at me.
Right, and I'll see what I can do.
Now I can see what I can do for you, but don't get mad and go tell him how broke he taxing.
Hey, but then there go.
Most of these niggas need managers. They can't talk.
Exactly.